And on to a programme postponed from 3 weeks ago and originally shown in 1974, in which two young players tackle the Elgar cello concerto at the Tortelier Masterclass.
In this series of masterclasses, held before an invited audience of music students, the great French cellist Paul Tortelier coaches advanced students and young professionals in six major works from the cello repertoire. In tonight's program, he works on Elgar's cello concerto. Composed in the aftermath of the First World War, this concerto was Elgar's last important work, and its air of restraint contrasts with the characteristic opulence of his pre-war music, written during an era that had now vanished. The two cellists taking part are Elizabeth Ramsey and Emma Ferrand. Elizabeth Ramsey was born in Edinburgh and studied at the Royal Scottish Academy of Music with Joan Dixon. She has given recitals throughout Scotland, and in 1971, at the age of 21, she won a scholarship to study with Paul Tortelier. Emma Ferrand was born in London and is 24. She studied with Douglas Cameron at the Royal Academy of Music and later with Pierre Fournier. Last year, she played at the Purcell Room and at St. Martin's in the Fields, and this February saw her debut recital at the Wigmore Hall. The accompanist is Geoffrey Prattley.
It's not easy, eh? But the beginning was very good, perhaps a little too slow. A little too slow, Liz. Because we lose the melody. When you break the chord, we lose Generally speaking, you complicate the situation for yourself by playing too slow. If you let it go everything, you can play 10 times better. Even the ending. You know, you act like somebody who needs air, and instead of opening the window, he closes more. You close on yourself. I have a frank basis impression. Would you do the beginning? And manage to have the melody and break the chord quickly, as a guitarist would do. He sings and plays the guitar at the same time. So he can have the melody and accompaniment. We must manage that. That's still better than the guitar. Like a man who wants to lift something heavier than he can lift. You know, even in the world championship, there are categories. You know what I mean?
Yes, sir.
You don't make box a man of 12 stones, I don't know in stones, kilo, yeah? With a man who... Yes. So you are not a man of 12 stones, I don't know the stone, eh? Yes. So, anyway, it is too slow. When you hear... and the music will be still better also. Now, re, ro, si, ro, la, do this. Go. You see? You don't suffocate? Must hold a little firmer. I know with my spike that is a little problem. Sometimes the cello doesn't hold firmly in between your legs. So don't take it too high so that to hold it. Good. Now, mademoiselle, would you be interested to do this? The contrast with your hair, you contrast with knees. So you are just fit for this place. The beginning of the phrase, of the not the not the the phrase itself, no, the melody. You see, you it is too realistic. You play as if it was fa, so fa, fa, but it is fa, fa. It is not a real chord like fa. We are not in D major. This sounds like D major. It should be, but play just one bar before. Listen. It must emerge, is that? Emerge. Will you try that? Very good. C'est ça. And the course of bow must be. Now, you are an immaculate person. You look like a virgin. And your playing must be immaculate. And even when you have a glissando, it is a little spot. It's a little sticky. It's like chewing gum in the mouth of an American. Mm-hmm. We really want fresh air, out of New York. Now, you have understood that. What is interesting, I want to give you another chance, please, about playing this ending, because you see, you must go ahead. You must go ahead. Play the end before, I mean, when it is for me, c'est ça. Good. Excuse me, here she plays a little too energetically. It is good, but we hear too much. I make a caricature. But can you play loud? Remember that. When you are afraid, you go slower. Some people, when they are afraid, they go quicker. But when you are afraid, you go slower and you make it worse and worse. Now, you see the beautiful scale? We are in E. The scale of E. It's interesting to see how scales are important in Elgar and in, I should say, in all good music. Do you agree? That's why we must study our scales, because we find scales. In Beethoven, you have beautiful... It's just a half a scale, always. And after... Out of pure scale. Shakespeare has said, music is a food of love. Had he been a musician, he would have added, scales and scales are the food of music. Remember that? Music is the food of love, scales are the food of music. And I discovered the Din Kapuria scale. You know that Indian scale? It is interesting. The intervals are arranged differently, well, as in other scales also. But perhaps you are interested to see how it goes. This is Elgar scale. Very English, and that is Indian scale. Pardon. I like to emphasize that you have the root of the soul of a people, of a country, in the scale already. Don't be afraid to be English, don't be afraid to be Indian, because we want variety. If you are Greek, you do that. The old Greek, the noble Greek of the antiquity. If you are Beethoven, you do... If you are Elgar, and if you are Indian, isn't it already musical? Music there already. We try Elgar. He lived in the time of Empire of India. He might have tried to bow to India and make the Indian scale instead of the Elgarian scale, English scale. Shall we try to do that? Yes. Ti-ra-ra-di. Take with me. We would get used to it. It is beautiful. Voilà, but it would be Indian. More passion. Our scale come from the Greek, who were not passionate. They were more merchant. They were great artists, but a little cold. A little cold. Philosopher, merchant, businessman, Greek, they are still. So, speaking of philosopher, now since we are at philosophy and scales, it's interesting to think about philosopher and composers. In their writings, philosophers teach us how to think. You must think this way about the world or God or what. But in their music, composers teach us how to love. It is a love lesson. Beethoven is pure love. Mozart is pure love. Schubert is pure love. I like that. Now let's go to the second movement. Extraordinary movement. I had my first prize in Paris with this movement. So I have a special affection for it. It's a good element. Will you do that? Yes? The opinion, yes? Like a wind again. Mm-hmm. It is beautiful.
Beautiful.
As I am here to criticize, I shall make little criticism, but it is nothing. This artistry means millions of years of progress for the humanity since the, how do you say, time of cave, of prehistoire, to reach this beauty. If the people in the street would know that, what respect they would have for you, in France anyway. You know, in France, when they meet a cellist, they say, ah, you play the cello. They just think that you spit on it. They don't know that it is a work of ever hours since we were born, almost. I began at 6, you began at 8. When you were 8?
12.
12, and you are more gifted than I. I wouldn't play like that. Now, perhaps the scherzo. You remember you finished. Do a little before. You must be at ease, yes. Do a little before. Hello. Six sensibles. That's beautiful. That's good. That's good. You want to try that a little? Yes. Also before. You are just lacking a little strength in your finger. You are perhaps cold now, because you haven't played in a few minutes. I have something to say to each of you. You are, it's good, very good. But your beginning is a little too realistic, with an accent, when you start. You see, and you start on the first thing. Could we have a start absolutely from the air? Let's try the beginning. We go, quicker. In the air. Perhaps now we should do a little of the slow movement, so beautiful. Anyway, it's very well to play that, like that. Oh, yeah. What a bow we need, huh? Mine is not so good today. Alors, the slow movement. The slow movement, you start, huh? Yes, please. C'est bien, Liz. Musically, I like very much. Perhaps we have too many bowings in the beginning, finally. Yes, in the beginning. I went too far. It's my fault. I gave you this bowing. When I made my recording, I thought I should have more bow. But you see, we sometimes go too far. Either not enough or too. That now it's too much. We're very pleased to hear this beginning, this piece by you too, Mademoiselle. Mademoiselle Emma. I said immaculate in the... But here it is different. It is not knife, it is a filling. Huh? So here you can have... some vocal, as if you sing. So if you do it here... It's not quite as good, huh? This is warmer, I think. I would like to know if you think it is warmer, the public also, if you... On the same string. Yes. It's more. Singing. Yes, we are all here. May I address it to you also, because I know you are musicians. We are all here to make it sing. Sing. If life sings, everything is marvelous. And it is said in even in Axiom. Well, Shakespeare said music is the food of love. It means music means singing. If you sing, it means you are in a good state. And the German says, böse Menschen haben keine Lieder. It means if you are angry, not hungry, but hungry also, because if you are hungry, you are angry. Like animals, we are. That's why I am also concerned with politics. But böse Menschen haben keine Lieder, it means that if you are in a bad state, you cannot even sing. And you know the French say that in one word. We have chant. Chant means song. And we have mais. Mais means without, or means bad song. So méchant. Méchant means wicked. If you are méchant, wicked, you cannot sing. Well, I made this little speech about the importance of song, of singing, but singing beautifully, as you do. Now, it will sing still better, I think, in the second part, if you start not both times, but not the first time, but the second time. Will you try that once? But you mustn't be afraid. Don't relax the pressure. Voilà. Better, it's better to miss it. The same higher. Miss it, but do it.
Yes.
The first who taught me that was Heifetz. He said, some people take very careful fingering. I don't. It's a gamble. And he's right. It's a bit of a gamble. So we must get this courage to risk when it is worthwhile like that. Yes. Now, the finale is a buoyant piece with played with exaltation. You agree? Mm-hmm. Alors, now, you are full of exaltation too. Please. 3, 4. Always. Go. You do too much. You overdo. It is enough. It is noble. Don't try to persuade me so much. You are very convincing, Liz. Believe me. Only one thing, again. What happens? You break the melody. Don't be méchant. Don't be wicked. Sing. böse Menschen haben keinen Leader. That is keinen Leader. It is méchant. Extraordinary, the French language. Huh? In one word, they say what the German says in 16 words. Because böse Menschen haben keinen Leader is only half of it. Before there is something. Oh yes, du lass dich ruhig sein, ruhig nieder. Böse Menschen haben keinen Leader. So it is a poem. French is méchant, without song, wicked. Now, you see, it's difficult. You see the difference? I place my chords in between, like the guitarist. Now, let's do the middle part. Little, you know, when we flow with the river, we flow with the river, I don't know if it's in English, when the river flows. Will you do that? Yes? No, since you art it, yes? Especially at the end, that's very, very joyful, yes. Before, the river could have been a little more beautiful. But it is just a matter of fingering, perhaps. I think we can have more capricious waves. Well, it is a matter also of wing. What is the... find very difficult to play like these bits of it. But perhaps you felt this abandon. Yes? Yes? We go on? Say ça. You know, this a beautiful after the D sharp. You must stay a little on this crest, the crest of the wave. Especially because of this. We must always feel the harmony inside. Inside, not only the surface of the water, but we must feel the undercurrent, the core, les courants. Currents, well, harmony. Alors, now, I think it would be nice to have the end, yes. Ta-ram, ta-ra-ram, ta-ra-ram. You know, La Belle Époque, the English who goes to Paris, huh? And they used to go to Paris when they had the little... They were more with moustache when they went that. That was the time. They knew how to be happy this time. Yes, you know the story. Forte. Forte, no, isn't it?
Forte for cello, piano for the
Yes, forte for the cello, of course. Not you, my poor. Ah, oh, poor Jeffrey. Tari. Hold the ball. Yes, this, we mustn't feel it is difficult, I also. But I think you don't prepare your gesture. For once, I shall be a little technical, if you allow me. Because it is necessary to get there in time. Nadine, with me. Now. You must come quicker. I shall do it once more. I want to do it well. I give you two to try. You see, if you push your shoulder and everything before, you will get there easier. Will you try? Allez, you have to try, like in the Olympic. Oh, that was very good. That was good. But could you make a crescendo? No.
Hello.
Play very bad today. Let's see. Bravo. Thank you. should finish here because there is nothing to add. But I have to tell you that the only little thing that troubles you is the chord. And it is a little just too bad because it is perfect. The rest is perfect. So it should be arranged here. After you finish so beautifully, what is the thing? Yes. So beautiful you do, it cannot be better, but that can be better. Those ones. Do that once. And that doesn't sound. Your bow is not flexible. You see, you must bend your bow and must have flexibility. So that, like a melody. Yes, right, we have no break. Because that is the ending, and we must finish well. And after the despair of the old man, because you feel, I suppose, the despair of an old man, though you are a young girl, do you feel the sadness, I mean despair, sadness, let's say. He lost his love, he lost his old, though there is no thing to happen for him. Huh? But then he's an Englishman, and he thinks, I must not... I want to play this last melody again. What is the last melody? Voilà, that's us, thank you. That is his dream over. His dream is over. That is the return of the slow movement. As you know, you play beautiful. Infinite. Infinite.
And bus tour of Europe tonight at 7:50 on BBC Two. Next Saturday.